Hello everyone, my name is Iris France, 胡椒连婉如. Today we're going to talk about marginal analysis. And using plain English, marginal means one additional. And marginal analysis just means that when you're making decision, you make decision one at a time. So to illustrate, we're going to use example. Suppose you're going to a friend's party and they have an open bar of beer. Now, suppose you're over 21. When you're deciding whether you're going to drink beer, you do not ask yourself, do I want to drink 5 beers today? No, you don't think like that. You will ask yourself, do I want to drink 1 beer? And after you finish that 1 beer, you will ask yourself, do I want to drink 1 additional beer? So you make decision one at a time. And let's think about the cost and benefit of drinking a beer. So the marginal benefit of drinking a beer means the benefit of drinking one additional beer. So the benefit will be, well, the taste is good if you like beer, and also it's fun because all your friends are drinking beer and you mingle with them, so you also want a can of beer. And maybe a beer quenches your thirst. You just arrived at the party and you're thirsty. What about the marginal cost of drinking a beer? Well, we know that just because you don't have to pay doesn't mean that it's costless to drink a beer. There are many costs associated with drinking a beer. So first of all, a beer has a lot of calories. So if you drink one can of beer, maybe that means you will have to exercise extra time the next day. And there's a health cost. We know that research shows that alcohol is bad for you, and there's no amount of alcohol drinking that's safe. So that's a cost, health. And if you start to drink more, you're going to start to feel tipsy and you're going to appear silly in front of your friends, and you don't like that. And finally, if you drink too much, eventually you cannot drive yourself home. You'll have to call Uber and you have to pay the Uber driver. So these are the marginal costs of drinking beer. Notice that the marginal benefit is going down. Thinking about this, when you're drinking the first can of beer, it tastes very good. And when you're drinking the second can of beer, even though the second can of beer is identical as the first can of beer, the second can of beer just doesn't taste as good as the first can. And likewise, the third can of beer does not taste as good as the second can of beer, even though all these cans of beers are identical. So you can see the marginal benefit is going down. What about the marginal cost? Well, let's think about being tipsy. When you drink the first can of beer, probably you don't feel anything. And the second can of beer, you start to feel something. And when you're drinking the third can, you probably start to feel dizzy already. So you can see that your marginal cost is going up. Now, when do you stop drinking beer? In this example, if you're rational, you are going to stop at the third can when your marginal benefit is equal to the marginal cost. Why? Because the first can of beer, the marginal benefit is still higher than the marginal cost. So when you're deciding whether you're going to drink a second can, you think, hey, it makes sense. The marginal benefit is still higher than the marginal cost. I am going to go ahead and have a second can. And so on and so forth. Until the marginal benefit is equal to marginal cost. Notice that after the third can, it does not make sense for you to drink any more beer. Why not? Think about the fourth can of beer. The marginal cost of feeling tipsy is higher than the marginal benefit of the good taste of the beer. So it does not make sense for you to drink the fourth can. If you're rational, you stop at the third can where your marginal benefit is equal to your marginal cost. And notice that you are also using marginal analysis when you're eating potato chips. When you have a big bag of potato chips, you don't open it and ask yourself, am I going to finish the whole pack? No, you make decision one at a time. You taste the first potato chip, it tastes good. And then if the benefit is higher than the cost, then you take the second potato chip. And you continue to eat until you feel you're satisfied. That's when your marginal benefit is equal to marginal cost. So this is marginal analysis. I hope this helps. I'll see you next time.